Hello everyone. Now continuing on to our topic of direct and inverse variation, we are going to discuss some word problems of inverse variation. Now have a look at this question. If 48 men can dig a trench in 14 days, how long will 28 men take to dig a similar trench? So here what is given in the question? That 48 men can dig a trench in 14 days. So here if we are having we employ less men, if the number of men will decrease, then the number of days is going to increase. So this is a case of inverse variation. So less men will take more days and more men will take the less days. So inverse variation is here. So one man can dig a trench in 14 into 48 days. So if you consider this, if only one man is digging the trench, he will have to do the work of 48 men by himself. So his work will be multiplied by 48. So he will take 14 into 48 days, and that's a lot of days. Now suppose he is joined by total number of men is 28. So 28 men, this work is now divided among 28 people. So this whole work is now divided by 28. So now the work will be completed in 24 days. So the required number of days is 28. Now we can do this question by drawing the table also. You can draw a table like this between the days and men. And again you have to write the same thing by there is inverse variation. Okay, we will first write whether it is direct variation or inverse variation. Now since it is inverse variation, this product between days and men, this product will remain equal. Okay, same. We know that now AB is constant. When we are talking in terms of inverse variation, this AB, this is A, this is B, the product remains the same. So we are going to make use of this concept. So 14 into 48 is equal to x into 28. And then x, that is the number of days, will come out to be 24. Now have a look at this second question. 45 cows can graze a field in 13 days. How many cows will graze the same field in 9 days? So same thing is here. If there are more cows, they can graze the field in less days. And if there are less cows, then they will graze the field in more days. So it is inverse variation. Okay. Now we know that 13 days, if there are in 13 days 45 cows can graze the field. So in one day 45 into 13 cows can graze the field. And if we are talking about 9 days, then this will be the number of cows that can graze the field in 9 days will be 45 into 13 upon 9, that is 65. So 65 cows can graze the field in 9 days. Now you can draw the table also. You can use the second method also. Okay. Then you will need to draw the table between number of cows and number of days. Okay. And then keep the unknown quantity x and then solve. Now have a look at this question. A bus covers a certain distance in 3 hours 20 minutes at an average speed of 45 km per hour. How long will it take to cover the same distance at a speed of 36 kilometers per hour? So the distance, the time given to us is in hours and minutes. So we are going to convert it into one unit. Either we will convert it into hours or we will convert it into minutes. So here we have converted it into minutes. You can convert it into hours also. Now we will use the table method to do. So what are the two things which are being compared? That are time and speed. Again, same thing with us. If the speed is more, less time will be taken. And if the speed is less, then more time will be taken. So it is inverse variation. That you can write it down yourself. Now, the time. In 200 minutes, it is 200 minutes is taken at a speed of 45 km per hour. Now, we do not know what time will be taken at the speed of 36 km per hour. So we have just drawn the table like this and we have kept the time as x. Now as it is a case of inverse variation, AP will remain constant. So that means 200 into 45 will be equal to x into 36. So x will be equal to 200 into 45 upon 36. And then you can cancel it out by 9. 9 4 is and 9 5s are 45, then 4 50s are 200, so the answer will come out 250 minutes, or you can divide it by 60 to get the answer 4 1 upon 6 hours, or you can write it 4 hours and 10 minutes. Okay, so bye for now.